मनी सर।
यस मैडम।
हाउ आर यू सर?
फाइन मैडम।
एंड थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर एक्सेप्टिंग अवर इनविटेशन एंड गिविंग एन इनसाइट अबाउट एप्लीकेशंस इन डिफेंस एंड एरोस्पेस टू विद आवर स्टूडेंट्स सर एंड योर एक्सपीरियंस विल हैव लॉट ऑफ वैल्यू टू आवर स्टूडेंट्स। थैंक यू
Thanks, madam.
We are making you to just because Sunday is a leave for us and we are making you to just work for us. We are extremely sorry for that.
And my special request, you are fixed on Sunday. Thanks. because yesterday I was having another two lectures for one IAS in Bangalore, one is in Kutu Engineering College. Yesterday I was occupied morning and afternoon.
Yes, sir. I know. You told me that. Yes, sir. But we know that our students are very eagerly waiting for your interaction, sir, because they enjoyed your interaction, and this even I have observed in our previous visit to our college, and we hope that this pandemic will go as early as possible, and we'll again invite you to our college to have an interaction with our students, sir.
Thanks, madam.
So,
maybe the students are from particularly ECE, madam.
ECE and EEE students are there, sir. Both of them. I think only few interested students from CSE background also are there present, sir. Very few.
Today morning, I talked to Professor Chandrasekhar.
Yes.
When he was paid maybe 1.5 hours, then I changed my slides.
Okay, sir. Okay.
The PDF slides. That's why adjustment problem. Anyway, I'll manage it.
Okay, sir.
Yes, sir. So, I technically prepared 63 slides for ECE, but then he rightly told the level of students that I changed a little bit, madam.
Yeah. No, majority will be of ECE and EEE background. So, the content will be more relevant to them. It doesn't have, and even the, we know that now people are working in interdisciplinary and transdisciplinary. So even a computer science student will know about electronics background as they need to work in core sectors. So it will have a value even for the CSE background students also.
It's audible, madam, clearly.
Yeah, yes, sir. It's
very
clear.
I have a little bit cold. Rarely I give lectures in video conferencing. Maybe for the 3 months only. 7 lectures. Earlier, I am good, comfortable in speaking in the hall. But anyway.
So it's a different experience even for us also, sir. We are learning at CH. Okay. Maybe the virtual conferences and virtual webinars and virtual interactions.
Care experience.
So it's a different experience and different learning even for us at this age. And you, we know that you adapt very fast to any type of learning environment, sir.
Perfecto. Great God for all blessings for all of us. It should go well. It will go well.
Yes, sir. Chandrasekhar, who is taking the lead in introducing, sir?
Balulata, madam.
Madam, good morning. Ready, madam. I'm here. Yes, madam. I'm ready, ma'am.
Yeah, you can start, Madhavi.
Yes, ma'am. Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Sir, shall we start, sir?
You can start, madam. Let them join. There are already 160 plus. They will be joining.
Professor, no need of spending time on introduction and all these things.
Just to want to have some brief introduction to students.
That's done. Okay. Please.
Yeah.
Please, madam, you can just start.
Good morning, one and yes. Good morning, one and all. So today we are having an eminent personality, Dr. V.N. Manigaru. So I request Principal Ma'am to have a brief introduction to the event and also our speaker, Ma'am. So can you speak few words, Ma'am?
You go ahead, Madhavi.
So respected principals, Dr. T. Kalpalata Reddy, Ma'am, SVEC, Dr. N. Sudhakar Reddy Garu, SVCE, and Dr. P.V.N. Reddy Garu. SVCK HODs of all the departments, energetic and enthusiastic students, a very good one to all. On behalf of our Department of ECE, myself, Madhavi, Associate Professor, feels privileged to introduce our eminent speaker. He is going to give a webinar on advanced electronic materials and devices for space and defense applications. It's organized by the ECE, Sri Venkatesh Engineering College. I want to thank here our management to stand as a backbone for organizing such an eminent speech to the students, and we are honored this morning with the presence of honorable speaker Dr. V.N. Manigaru, scientist, Center for Materials for Electronics Technology, CMET, Department of Electronics and Information Technology, Government of India. Sir has worked as a postdoctoral fellow, visiting scientist at NTU, Changhua, Taiwan, and Italy, and so many countries. Engaged in the areas of semiconductor crystals, wafers, and thin film structures, device fabrication, and VLSI clean room aspects. He delivered more than 120 lectures, invited speakers, keynote speakers, and addressed over 18 years the students, various universities, NITs, engineering colleges in Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, etc. He broadly covered some concept principles on current practices and trends in advanced micro-optoelectronic and nano-electronic materials, digital manufacturing, device fabrication, classical in practicing technologies, solar energy, and nanomaterials. For the past years, Dr. Mani have been engaged in advanced R&D for the development of indigenous process technology for ultra high purification of gallium and indium to 7+ purity level at CMET Hyderabad. He carried out major projects in DIT, DST, DRDO projects. So this is a great opportunity for all the students to have such an eminent speaker today. So I request all the students to make use of the inputs and the knowledge which is going to be delivered by the speaker today. So thanks for giving this opportunity to all. Now I request Dr. V.N. Manigaru to take over the session, sir.
Thank you very much, Professor and Madam. Respected colleague authorities, very respected active principal, Kalpalata Reddy garu Madam, and HODs of EC and EEE, other faculty members, my dear young faculty guys, and my dear students, it is my pleasure to be associated with you through this meeting. See, I always love to teach and share my research ideas in various forums for the past 25 years. See, students will be very much happy. The trend, electronic trend is meeting in every passing decade. Earlier, we have vacuum tubes based electronics technology, some 1930s, 40s. Now, thanks to the invention of silicon, germanium, semiconducting materials, especially in the thin film forms, that paved the way of birth of planar technology. Now, the microelectronic silicon technology has evolved for the past 5 years. So we are talking about if it is possible to merge the existing microelectronics technology and existing nanotechnology to realize nanoelectronics, an advanced, superior, performance-based, cost-effective technologies. Advanced research activities are underway, especially in Western countries and China, to some extent in India. See, in one sense, my dear young faculty members and students, we are all happy to note the trends. World has become a global village thanks to the development of advanced electronics technologies, amalgamating information technology, communication technology, internet technology. The bigger world has become a small village. Electronic technology made it possible. See, coming to our own status or scenario. See, Indian scientists, professors, engineers should feel happy. Using our mathematical simulation, modeling brains, computational brains, mathematics brains, and our materials and device technologists, engineers' efforts, we made it possible at lowest cost, our moon mission and the Mars mission. Generally, we have proved, Indian engineers, scientists, professors, we have proved our worth by taking up to those major space programs. So the electronics technology, electronics materials, devices really made wonderful revolution in 21st century. See, earlier the trend was a country's strength was decided based on a developing country, rich country, poor country, based on the earlier economic concept of having more gold reserves, gold and foreign exchange reserves. Now the trend has changed. Thanks to the particular technology of electronics, governing various subfields, whether you name it, electronic components, devices, gadgets, systems, internet, off-net cloud computing, big data analytics, nanorobotics, and robotics, so on. But then, now knowledge power, technology power is the deciding factor for any country's hallmark in the global map. How many satellites, missions you have carried out, how many missiles you have, how many atom bombs. Of course, the country's security point of view, country's technology point of view. Now, the converging trend, each young student, young faculty will be happy to figure out from the technology forecasting studies, especially in electronics industries. The trend is, how intelligently you are going to use your space assets, defense assets, even atomic power assets, atomic agency assets, for societal applications. In some 70s, 80s, up to 90s, most of the atomic agencies assets, space assets, defense assets, mainly for maybe security purpose. But the trend has changed in the past 10 years around the globe. At the same time, catering to the needs of security and other aspects is a major. But 30% all space programs, defense programs, atomic energy programs is aiming, tilting towards societal application, amalgamating security purpose plus societal applications, sub areas. That is an interesting trend. Normally, maybe around some two decades back, a broad and vast concept was there in the developing countries in general, particularly in India. See, the perception, wrong perception is, if you study, if you take up software, information technology, you will have a lot of job opportunities, but you underestimate the role of hardware, core subjects like ECE, EEE, even to some extent mechanical engineering, chemical engineering, material science engineering, basic sciences. That was alarming. Now trend is changing. Young faculty members, especially students, should feel happy. Now the trend is going, maybe becoming obsolete. All fields, basic sciences, engineering sciences, technology fields, joined together, becoming interdisciplinary, multidisciplinary. A physics fellow, chemistry fellow, put efforts to separate silicon, low-grade silicon, from sand SiO2. Then you have to refine, you have to purify, convert amorphous silicon, semiconductor silicon, into crystalline silicon. You grow a crystal, then you prepare a wafer for chip, then cleaning, rinsing, washing, cutting, polishing, then realizing IC people, integrated circuits fabrication, ECEEE people, creating active regions, source drain, then do variety of photolithography, implantation, then SORAT 42 fabrication steps, realizing a component, using component, realizing a device, using devices assembling, realizing a gadget, using gadget, you realize consoles, using consoles, ultimately you realizing the equipment or whatnot. But in all these developments, role of physics people, chemistry people, modeling mathematics people, material science people, chemistry for qualification, mechanical people, cutting, polishing, a variety of interdisciplinary. Colloquially, jovially, I used to tell in variety of conferences, after these people behind the scene, friends in ECE, typically semiconductor fabrication people, VLSI people, they produce a component. Then we realize a laptop, a gadget, selling that gadget, the market, services, brains up, marketing strategy, MBA fellow role is also required. So no, don't underestimate basic sciences. I am not friend of basic sciences. I am not enemy of hardware sciences. I am not friend of hardware. I am not friend of software. I am not enemy for engineering or technology. I am not friend, friend of sciences. But all fields got merged. That is one of the real transformation in the past 30 years. Everybody role is required. See, there was a concept in colleges. I used to go to a lot of colleges. The trend is Telugu literature fellow, when you studied one MA Telugu literature fellow will not be respected by MA economics fellow. Then MSc physics fellow won't respect that MA economics fellow. ME civil engineering fellow won't respect that physics fellow, MSc physics fellow. Triple E fellow won't respect the civil engineering fellow. M.Tech fellow won't respect the other curriculums. That was the wrong concept. They have given lot of thrust for the past 20 years on software. One way or other way, sorry to tell, we ignored basic sciences to some extent. We ignored hardware manufacturing. A country's strength cannot be built on only software, information technology, internet communication. Intelligent technology should be amalgamating software and hardware. You realize the intelligent technology which is working for your amenability, for your tailoring aspect, for easiness. That should be the intelligent technology. That is the knowledge power, technology power. Now India is slowly realizing. My dear young ECE students, triple E students, pardon me, CSE students, I am not enemy. All should go together. Hardware people will have lot of job opportunities. Core subject people, ECE, typically mechanical, all for that matter, even material science and engineering people will have a lot of opportunity. Because man-made problems created in the name of technology development in the past 30 years, water crisis, water problem, water crises, availability of water, energy crises, the technology created electronic waste dumping, their recovery, cleaning your mother hair. Where the role of core subject people, starting from basic sciences, engineering, technology sciences, even technology innovation ideas are required to solve this problem. In this direction, core subjects will have its own role. In between, for the past maybe 10 to 15 years, it has been neglected in this country. Now government also equally projecting, putting lot of budgets to have our semiconductor pack in the pack. Industries in Hyderabad, in Bangalore, in another 5-10 years, we will be having more thrust concentration on core areas, especially hardware, especially manufacturing. Manufacturing and software technology should go hand in hand together to realize a wonderful amalgamation technology. That technology, that concept will make the technology in a small country. So, coming to, I want to share here and there without bringing some boredom, covering only subject. It's a complicated subject, which we are working for specialized space and defense programs for developing material to some component for our mandate agencies, ISRO and DRDO. See, a very good engineering student, a very good scientist, very good professor, dealing with engineering, technology, science subject, first of all, they should have a cool temper. Take it easy policy. Because in their career, in their life, many professors, scientists, engineers will face lot of downs, failures, only few successes. So a basic characteristic feature of the scientist, engineer, professor, doctor, should have a calm temperament, cool temperament, take it easy temperament, not to be sentimental, not to be sensitive. You should be neutral. That is the essence. Then only your mind will work with the concept of why, when, how, where. If this approach is not working to solve a problem, why don't you look other concepts? So there is no question of philosophy for a text or literature or type of type to become a very good student of science, engineering, technology. As I told, I am not enemy of software information technology. I am not friend of hardware. But you see the difference. Science concept is one thing. Engineering concept is another thing. Science concept, engineering concept, technology concept, technology innovation concept. Students, even young faculty may go through, because of paucity of time, I may cover here and there some slides. These concepts, clearly they should understand. Read lot of literature that is available. It's sensible literature, non-sensible literature. Go for sensible. Preach the students. Teach the students. My humble request is, the middle level faculty member, young faculty member, they have a lot of opportunity for their own learning in a rural colleges, in a semi-rural towns colleges. First, inculcate, rekindle young students' mind. Simple example. You can explain science concept, engineering concept, technology concept, technology innovation concept. Similarly, research concept, basic research, applied research, research and development concept, pilot level production concept, manufacturing concept, mass production. How to develop a prototype? How do you define a prototype zip? Simple example, you can tell stories in the introductory classes in the first week, or even let us take few weeks, no problem, before going to the real, your pressurized university syllabus, whatnot. Then that first week or 2 weeks, the first year students, you bring him, you rekindle their passion, interest, telling the story. I used to tell one of my close friend from Calcutta University for the past 20 years, I listened some of his lectures in major universities. One day he was explaining, I taken a slide also, the credit goes to him. He was explaining, what do you mean science, engineering, technology? He was given example, Albert Einstein, a great physics professor, maybe the founder father for atom bomb concept, great physics professor Einstein, taken, available, proven, tested, consistent concepts of mathematics, physics. He derived an equation. That is E equal to mc square, foundation equation for atom bomb development. That is the role of a science, that is the role of a scientist, that is the role of a physics professor Einstein, that is the contribution come from science subject. Then Enrico Fermi, a quasi-engineer, interdisciplinary physics person as well as engineering person, he taken that E equal to mc square equation, he proved using engineering brain, he proved that equation by constructing a small working model or prototype or a test jig, that is a small atom bomb. Then a technologist taken that atom bomb, then applied his technological brain, improving the safety aspect by using the concept of arresting neutrons so that to control the chain reaction for mindless baking. Then yes, mainly technologist includes the concept of cost of production, cost of its final product when it goes to the market. Safety aspect, some aesthetic look, that is the role of technology field, that is the contribution of technologist. Innovation, once you have the product, concept, everything, how intelligently you use to update, bring down the cost effective, mainly variety of manipulations for our own intelligent operation. That is where technology innovation. Now we are the world technology forecast report says, as far as electronics, gadgets or technology concerned, knowledge innovation, technology innovation is the thumb mark of a competition. Take an example, my dear young faculty members, there are variety of laptops, Samsung make, HTL make, Lenovo make, even maybe Sony make. But Sony certain laptops will be costly, suppose 70,000 rupees. The moderate is same brand, concept, same everything. Brand is different, concept construction same. Sun laptops 40,000, which I am using. But in the Sony, the innovative features, RAM science, so on. There, they are capturing the young customers. That is the concept of innovation. One single point I want to tell to the young faculty members and the listening young students. See, India is very good in science. We are very good in mathematics from Vedic days. We are strong, analytically strong, our analysis ability. Thanks to Britishers' rule, 600 plus years, we are very good in English. We are very good in mathematics, Indians. Sincerely hardworking people, analytical strong, everything thinking ability. That's why we are doing very well in software. India is good in science, good in research, good in software. Maybe we are not that much good in research and development. We are very poor in translating R&D ideas into meaningful application oriented gadgets for society. We are in one sense, we are very good in software. Our guys are doing very well everywhere. That trend has to be changed. We should give equal importance to hardware. Simple example, in this great country, Sasivi Raman, where he studied in Presidency College, found out the reason on a clear sunny day, cloudless day, why sky color is blue. He got the Nobel Prize. He found out the reason in white light. There are seven colors, Vidyard colors, one blue color scatters based on the quantum mechanics, spectroscopic concept. The BT of Raman effect, people used to tell two concepts. Sasivi Raman proved his why sky color is blue concept using available mathematical concept, quantum mechanical concept. Then theoretically he proved, verified, tested with repeatable, reproducible results. Apart from the beauty of that Raman effect, apart from theoretical verification proof, he constructed a small spectrometer to test his discovery experimentally. Used locally available electrical components, optical components. For that, he mainly worked in IACS Calcutta, Indian Association for Cultivation of Science. You should remember, now change, earlier days, Sambar fellows, Tamilians, Bengalis are brainy people. They were dominating in science and technology. Earlier civil services, they are brainy people. Some state people, they will involve in business and all these things. He did most of his work in Calcutta. He never used imported electrical components or optical components to construct a small test spectrometer. He proved it experimentally also. He was an Indian. He proved that effect by theoretically. He also shown us to construct a spectrometer. Nowadays it is called as Raman spectrometer. Raman spectrometer is a wonderful tool for chemistry research to know the molecular structure, to know the purity, contamination of chemicals, certain chemicals, but mainly from 1995 onwards. Raman spectrometer is a wonderful tool in electronic industry. That too, nowadays, nano-electronic materials, devices development, Raman signature spectrum is a wonderful requirement to test your quantum transistor, having 5 nanoparticle size, maybe some 3-4 nanometer. So Indians are very good in research. The funny thing, sad thing is that now in India, no company is manufacturing Raman spectrometer. We are importing them. That means we are very good in research and development also to some extent, but very poor in translating that idea into meaningful application. That's why I always tell, somehow we have neglected. One professor in SRM University, some 6 months back, we went for inaugurating a student branch. Look, Dr. Mani, you are a scientist, you are from a Ministry of Electronics, where my space field was doing very well. After independence, we are strong. Defense anyway, because of importance, criticality, defense is doing well. our atomic energy programs also very well. But why in this great country not much importance given to semiconductor fabrication, component fabrication, VLSI? In this country, no major facility for M.Tech students, young faculty to do their PhD in VLSI, hardware concept. Everybody does modeling, simulation. 99.9% of the ECMB faculty or students do PhD in India by only through studying theoretically modeling simulation concept. What is the problem? Yes, ask. Very, very wonderful policy made. I was really for a few minutes stumbled. Very, very perturbed. See, because how to answer? Earlier I can give, so I was giving so many stories, this reviews. But then, Professor, very good question. Now I am going in a very routine, reviewing some tamasha slides. But give me some 1 or 2 hours. During lunchtime, I'll apply my mind. Definitely, I'll come to you before my leaving from this place. Because I am a ministry employee, that too senior employee. It is my duty. See, then near very during lunchtime, one professor from Malaysia was also giving has given lecture. I was generally discussing. One young professor thrown me a very challenging question, but he gave some ideas. Okay, that the Indian scenario, that is not much, but I took it to notice. Then I recollected one technology forecasting report for our ministry, somewhere prepared in 90s. Status of hardware, electronic materials, devices, components, research in India. Some gray paragraph points I got it. First of all, the problem for hardware development, semiconductor fab, laboratory, foundry, factory establishment, main problem is capital intensive. It requires huge manpower, trained, skilled, specialized manpower. It requires a lot of special systems, which requires a lot of budget. A software man, maybe he can spend one lakh, he will have also maybe tab and connections, everything. He can write program, he can do modeling, but to set up a fabrication facility to produce silicon-based diodes or gallium arsenide-based high-mobility electron transistors. It requires huge infrastructure, capital, money investment. That is one reason. During the this colloquial, that report point came to me, my rescue, during lunchtime. Of course, I replied to the person in the hotel, SRM hotel, around 4 o'clock in the evening after everything was over. Major problem, another problem, during independence for space research, Vikram Sarabhai, for atomic energy research, Homi Bhabha, stalwarts were there, role models, the persons who can influence then the Prime Minister, Jawaharlal Nehru, higher authorities, impressing the need of the speed. We missed a bus. Only to some extent, A.S. Rao was a close friend for atomic energy then chairman Homi Bhabha, late Honorable Homi Bhabha. He brought, because of his friendship, he convinced, impressed him. I said, we have those days Electronics Corporation of India, ECL in Hyderabad. So at the time, there were no guardrails to push this semiconductor technology in general. So from that time onwards, we lagged the bus. Now it is the right time. New policymakers realizing now in another 10 years, one can have lot of things. Now, about the stories, coming to the topic which I am going to discuss, maybe most of the interdisciplinary materials, that means ore, silicon dioxide, for example, that is the ore, sand. You have to separate silicon, low grade silicon, then you have to refine the silicon. Then you get high purity silicon. Then you convert amorphous to crystalline silicon. My dear young faculty members, my dear young students, there are select materials in electronics. We all know silicon, germanium are the dominant 90% materials, their compressed devices for the existing microelectronic technology. 99.9 purity is the purity requirement for consumer-based electronic gadget, silicon germanium. Silicon is a wonderful material, but nobody uses silicon in amorphous form. What is the difference between amorphous silicon and crystalline silicon? In amorphous silicon, atoms are arranged in a zigzag manner. There is no periodicity. There is no similarity. You have to convert that high purity silicon, 99.9 silicon amorphous to crystalline silicon by using sophisticated, maybe capital intensive, specialized technology called crystal growth. If you want to produce bulk wafers for chip. But there are thin film deposition techniques. No use of amorphous germanium, amorphous silicon, amorphous gallium arsenide, maybe zinc oxide materials for advanced electronics. Students should remember. Even students, I am very sorry to say, I used to go to VIT, SRM University, even IAS Bangalore, some IITs for selections, assistant process selections. Our young students, wonderful GPS, 7.5, 8.2, 9.2. But fundamental questions, they are not thorough. The Google, the information technology, your internet technology made so many advantages, but it spoils, it creates lethargy. Present day students, I am sorry to say, not very good about concepts, foundation, subject, principles, but good gratings. I asked one student, how do you understand the concept of diode, Zener diode, photodiode, laser diode? No question. Then I asked, how do you explain? You are going to join as an assistant professor in SRM University. A rural guy, Tamil medium or Telugu medium, comes. He is, let us assume, he is not very familiar. You cannot tell definitions like me, story telling scientist Made. In a crisp way, tell him the difference between electrical engineering and electronic engineering. Okay, electronics and communication. You have to tell the difference in his local language or in a simple English, the different concept difference between electrical engineering and electronic engineering. No answer. But his grades, 8.2. So in that sense, the young faculty members, young students, even software students, computer students should always must respect these other disciplines. When we put efforts, physics fellow, chemistry fellow, materials fellow, ECE fellow, triple E fellow, chemical engineering fellow, material science and engineering mechanical fellow, when we put all our efforts, we develop first of all high pure silicon material, then we develop crystal. Using crystal, we develop wafer substrate. Using the substrate as a chip, you develop your components. So much contribution. When we don't do, then we don't give a gadget like maybe your laptop, where you will test your software program, where you write. So our role is important. Even CSE people, ECE people, fundamentally they should know what is silicon, where it comes, what is intrinsic silicon, what is extrinsic silicon, how to dope, how to fabricate a crystal, from crystal how to get a chip, using chip, how to create source drain gate active regions, what are the steps, maybe I colloquially tell four steps, implantation, photolithography, marking, everything, but there are 47 steps. All students should know. Is the whatever you are seeing, Ravana color Rajinikanth in Shivaji movie, equal color of Shreya, all graphics, thanks to Shankar. But the foundation is silicon. Without silicon, you don't have laptop. Then you don't do all photoshopping, editing, coloring, everything. Give importance. Students should know what are the properties of silicon. There is no value for intrinsic pure silicon. You have to convert it to N-type, P-type to work it for your convenience, bipolar. Bipolar. Then students should know its density, its melting point, its mobility concept, conductivity concept, resistivity concept, these kind of things. Those are the foundation for your house, which you are sitting room. The foundation unit cell is brick. Similarly, for any electronic gadget, foundation is silicon, germanium, or other semiconductors. They should know the basic principles, even when they go for interview. Even though you are going for a software field, simulation field, that is a different issue. Foundation, principles, concepts are missing among the students, overconfidence, because these internet spoils them. They have confidence that we have all the data. I'm very sorry to say. Now, in our laboratory, I am coming from Ministry of Electronics Laboratory called Center for Materials for Electronics Technology. We have three laboratories. One laboratory is at Pune, another laboratory is at Tiruchur, Kerala. My laboratory is Hyderabad, where I am from. We have three different mandates by the Ministry of Defense, Department of Space, Atomic Energy, to some extent, some bilateral projects of DST, so on, DRLS, Atomic Energy. We have been given mandate to develop certain indigenous critical technologies, mainly for advanced electronics applications. Your laptop, mobile, TV are consumer electronics-based gadgets that we don't call advanced electronics. My dear young faculty members, students, I would like to stress one point here. So, consumer electronics applications, advanced electronics applications, defense electronics applications, space electronics application, one thing. Technologically important materials for advanced application, another concept. These all are electronics components, devices, I am telling. But space electronics application, defense electronics application is one concept. Aerospace electronics applications, aero defense special applications is different. To give you an idea, a glimpse in a colloquial way, when I traveled last time, thanks to Professor Kalpulata Reddy, active madam, I have seen from the Chennai also. Very, very, some old guys, terrorist lady, military lady, or HOD, they used to tell one Tamilian guy, I'm from Tamil Nadu, one Tamilian, assistant professor guy, with respectfully, sir, this your friend, this Kalpulata madam, by her look, the way she executes, the shade, the way she demands, the military type of HOD, sir. So, in that sense, the policy change should be not as a scientist having 29 years of experience. A military type policy leader is required to transform amalgam. We are strong in software, but amalgamming the gap of that hardware core subject facility to transform. That type of military vision, real dynamic kind of Omi Baba, Vikram Sarabhai, at least if it comes, that concept comes, bold, visionary, so implement, we can at least bridge the last gap of almost 40 years. We missed the bus in the semiconductor area, the hardware area. So we do work for these agencies for special needs. For example, where I am coming from Hyderabad, we have been asked to develop certain purification technologies. We will get low-grade material. We will employ variety of electro-refining, electrochemistry, chemical engineering, crystallization, cleaning, rinsing, washing, packaging, contamination control, these concepts to develop 90% grade silicon by employing these material science metallurgy concepts to make it 99.995. Then, why I am in between diverted? Space applications, electronic application, one concept, aerospace. Let us assume Kalpulata Reddy offered me a flight pair coming from Hyderabad to Tirupati and back. I remember long time back. Maybe to Chennai, I don't know, Tirupati or your college. It was a small, at the time, spike jet, 125 passengers capacity. It will fly above the ground, 35,000 feet above the ground. attitude. Aero world means attitude above the ground. Suppose if I want to go to Washington, America from Hyderabad, I'll fly from bigger aircraft, Airbus, Boeing aircraft. The passengers capacity depending upon 300 or 250 or 350. That international aeroplane will fly above the ground, 85 to 90,000 feet above the ground. These will be decided by airport authority based on radar, based on traffic. I don't want to go inside. But when we launch a satellite or some medium range missiles, the how much height it will be there, sometime 1 lakh feet above the ground. Think of 1 lakh kilometer above the ground, maybe Mars mission, Moon mission. In that high altitude, there will be cosmic rays, gamma rays, to withstand different conditions, to withstand that type of hard radiation. Normally, many aeroplanes, especially in international aeroplanes, satellites, outer enclosures, their components, their systems, mainly radiation protection painting coated. That is one concept. Another concept, using high quality structurally, chemically, electrically, optically, strength-wise, mechanical engineering point of view, hardness-wise, then such quality material can withstand the radiation. It won't corrode, erode, or lifetime will be rugged one, bigger one. That is the reason why we are using special high quality components, devices for aerospace electronics applications. See, your consumer electronic gadget mobile in the form of active components like diode, transistor, passive components like resistor, capacitor, whatnot, inductor, are mainly using 99.9% medium grade, consumer grade silicon material. But 99.9999 purity based silicon, germanium, gallium arsenide are used to produce components exclusively for aerospace electronic application. That purity will make it withstand. And moreover, high purity means better mobility, conductivity, carrier concentration. You can manipulate refractive index, light band gap, optics to electrics, electrics to optics. Simple example students should understand. Silicon, germanium are elemental semiconductors, single element. They have limitations. One is indirect band gap. You can use only for certain application. New semiconductors evolved after 1950. Gallium arsenide, binary, two element. Gallium arsenide, indium phosphide, zinc oxide, off-rate LED material, gallium nitride, silicon carbide. Their binaries, their ternaries, their mixers, thick films, thin films, later evolution. It has superior properties compared to conventional silicon and germanium. That's why those kind of materials are mainly used for special advanced electronic applications to send the information, to receive the information, to process the information in satellites, in missiles, whatnot, control systems. So we have been given mandate to develop certain select materials, gallium arsenide for gallium, cadmium telluride for cadmium telluride, cadmium and tellurium for cadmium telluride, silicon carbide, germanium in high purity form. High purity form. Purity means students will get confused. ECE, EEE students, physics fellow, chemistry fellow, metallurgy fellow, material science fellow will understand. We are given a colloquial example, my dear young students. When I mean, what I mean to say, 99.99 purity, that 49, it's a percentage purity concept. Let us assume you are developing high purity, 1 centimeter solid silicon black for producing a diode from the silicon black material for defense application, electronic application. Assume the level purity we are expecting, we want 99,099 particles should be silicon. One particle may be an impurity like aluminium, like sand, like my maybe dandruff. Total particles 1 lakh. Out of 1 lakh total particle in that silicon 1 centimeter block, 99,999 should be silicon. That is the purity concept. That we call 99.99. That is the concept. Such is the level. See, I think this is the Women's Engineering College, I think. Sarcastically, jovially, I used to tell in the conference gatherings, the conference hall, most of the colleges which I go, 65% of the students are girls. Maybe 30-20% are boys. Out of which only some good boys, 10 people only will be sitting in the front row. The last back benchers watching their maybe girlfriend's photo or last. I used to ask, in this 500 years of history, only some handful of 4 or 5 women scientists, women professors, women researchers got Nobel Prize. But in India, they are the top numbers in education and employment also. But they are not getting so many Nobel laureates, the gents, we got many prizes in various disciplines. Why, I ask one M.Tech girl student, sir, even if you are a scientist, those gents who got Nobel Prize, in their that recognition, our role is also indirectly, silently we play. So I was very happy the reply of the student. See, mother plays a dominant role in children's development. Nowadays, even in entire family development, Sassi Viraman biography, I read somewhere old papers. He was already IAS at the time, ICS, Indian Civil Service guy. His father, already you are a collector grade qualification. What is a fool? You are an idiot or a crack fellow leaving the job. But Craig, by knowing his passion, by love for that subject, he became a Nobel laureate for our country. So in that way, as that student told, we also imbibe the basic training for children, even contribute, make conducive environment to make a Nobel laureate. So don't underestimate our role, sir. Whether we get Nobel Prize or not, here also, main reason, whatever the Nobel laureate scientist got their wives plays a role. So, my dear young students, because your software, your communication, electronics, all good and bad technologies transformed the concept of teaching pedagogy, concept of basic research thinking, research and development thinking, product development thinking, now innovation, technology innovation, knowledge power, technology power. But mainly, I used to go to so many colleges, some selections, young guys. What I see missing, communication skills are majority of the students not good, especially engineering students. The other sciences, social and humanities, they will be always good. But basic sciences students are very good. But engineering is somewhat different discipline, the problem solving brain. But now trend is that you want to be a very good engineer, you should have subject stuff as well as these extracurricular activities or skills. Communication skills, very important, you should develop. Adaptability, flexibility, smart approaches according to the situation, that is very important. And exams are also radically pedagogy, teaching pedagogy as a thinking. Concentrate in this to compete this rat race area, especially your engineering side, especially the software, making your life very, very difficult. Rat race. So these are the young students should think of. Told, we are very good in software, but we missed the semiconductor revolution. Even we are importing light emitting diode bulbs, we are arranging, assembling and selling. We don't have. The conceptually what our, at least India should become superpower. His prediction was 2020. Very important. The young faculty members, my dear seasoned senior professors, should rekindle young students, imbibe certain philosophies. Now, core subjects period has come. There is a scope for amalgamating, merging the software concept and the microelectronics hardware concept. We will have intelligent new technologies. We have to encourage them. Yes, but it is not the philosophy by politician encouraging. Trends are going in that, especially nanomodernization, these kind of things definitely has electronics field as a major role. It will impact. See, my dear young faculty members, students, you know, packing is one concept. Colloquial consumer commerce packing is different. Packaging is nothing but a very large scale integration, ultra large scale integration. There are debates, the ideas, merging, emerging, MEMS with VLSI. Whether a VLSI alone will work for developing nano size transistor, whether we should use both judicially going on. But packaging, how intelligently you are assembling hundreds of diodes, transistors, capacitors, resistors in a small given chip area, that is called colloquially packaging. How minimum available space for maximizing the putting your components is a wonderful emerging area. An example, now I am using my tab. I am going to operate it for 2 hours, let us say. The electromagnetic voltage, then electromagnetic field, heat is produced, dissipate the heat, how to cool the system, how to manage interference, noises. This is a wonderful field. Any bright students, good students who are interested in going higher studies, MTech, there are a lot of opportunities, research opportunities, job opportunities to know this packaging area. Electronic waste recycling, recovering, packaging, nano electronics materials components development, nano robotics, cloud computing, big data analytics have become or becoming very close intermediate interdisciplinary subjects, multidisciplinary subjects, where core guys, ECE guys, triple E guys, even like me, 700 scientists, merging from physics come electronics, will have a lot of opportunities apart from other subjects. Even a mathematics fellow, computer modeling fellow, simulation fellow is the first man to concentrate in these kind of areas. Okay, joke slide to explain the packaging concept for the young students. This is a wonderful thing, yeah. As I told, we missed the hardware revolution. Started from 1960 to 85. We are very weak in semiconductor technology. We don't have real fabrication facility to produce a simple transistor diode, except some space laboratories or some defense laboratories like Semiconductor Complex Limited, Chandigarh. But in that sense, is it worth to spend thousands of crores and develop all these advanced technologies, including electronics, for the application of space and defense? How will you reply? If a IAS officer asking a scientist, a policy maker, then you should think up. You should give in justified way. See, many young faculty, many young M.Tech students, B.Tech students, they don't know one simple concept of how the history of germanium, silicon. Please remember instance. See, knowing the property, semiconducting properties of silicon germanium is the first human achievement as far as electronics field development is concerned. There are a variety of metals, alloys, compounds, but first people know silicon, a metal, is having semiconducting properties. Neither fully conducting nor not at all conducting like metals. Whether not at all conducting like insulators. It's a middle class, maybe rich class, middle class, very, very lower class. These semiconductors, electronic materials comes under middle class. But first time when they know silicon germanium are the wonderful having wonderful semiconducting properties, they produced, they separated, refined, purified, prepared silicon, germanium as pure semiconductor elements. That is the second achievement in the annals of electronics field development. Which tube electronics of 30s, 40s? The major achievement, it was possible to deposit as thin films like paper thickness by using variety of deposition techniques, variety of testing methods, characterization methods, starting from X-ray, scattering electron microscopy, atomic force microscopy, testing their properties, N-type or B-type, their doping technologies, then controlling their defects, chemical purity, chemical perfection, physical perfection, electrical perfection, studying their optical. That is the real revolution which took place somewhere around 50s, 60s. That is the real revolution which took place somewhere around 50s, 60s. That is students should know. But one more contradicting, confusing maybe ideas that are in the minds of young faculty members, young students, I found out during my staff selection, assistant professor selections in VIT SRM and in any conferences, first germanium was tried for producing a transistor somewhere in 1940s to 50s in Bell Laboratory. High purity germanium was first used to transistor application. Later on, based on its intrinsic properties, other material consideration, property consideration, now 99% silicon is the best material for your diode transistor. Germanium is for your detectors. That is based on material intrinsic properties. Now nobody uses germanium for your transistor, electronic material. Germanium is optical material. Silicon is an electronic material. Students should know. First of all, a very good engineer, very good scientist, very good professor, very good doctor should always be habit of questioning mind. Research bent of mind, research bent of thinking, probing with colloquial questions, philosophy questions. Why? When? Where? How? Especially young professors who are teaching the students, for that benefit only, I prepared this slide taken from some assistant professor in VIT long ago. You present day generation students don't know. People like me, Professor Kalpalata, our generation is different. At the time, standard Millman Archaeus books were there, standard solid state devices, semiconductor devices books. Knowingly, unknowingly, fortunately, unfortunately, we studied them across the spectrum, along the spectrum. That's why Dr. Mani or Professor Chandrasekhar Kalpalata Reddy confidently, honestly say, whatever we little know 30 years back, now we are very struggling with the daily updates, this field, that is a problem. But we were thorough with the concepts, fundamentals, but present day generation is not. Because variety of information pumped in the net spoils the younger generation. So in that sense, 20 years back, an Indian science teacher will teach 8th class students science subject like this. Example, science teacher will ask the Indian science student, a student, 8th class student, where do fish live? Happily that student will stand and reply, madam, fish lives in water. Then teacher will tell, very good, sit down. But the same concept handled by Western country science teacher will ask the student, where do fish live? Student will reply, fish live in water. Next question will come from Western country science madam. Why fish can live only in water? Why it cannot live in the ground or soil? If at all it has to live, what body part fish should have? Lungs. Then corollary, ancillary question, what is the function of lungs? It helps in breathing by separating oxygen in the air. This is the best methodology to rekindle the way of teaching. It is not only teaching concept, even research concept. Scientists, engineers should think in that way. This is the best way. Anyway, this I skip. The concept of science, engineering technology is mainly based on verified, tested, proved, repeatable, reproducible, consistent facts. There is no question, there is no place for philosophy here. If A equal to B, B equal to A. My dear ECE student, triple E students, one more bombarded question. See, my style is many senior professors, many sensitive professors like Kalpalata Reddy, she'll be angry. They have some problems, difficulties mingling with me or mixing with me. One sense, example, not to act. But my habit is mingling, mixing, going to the level of students. One day, maybe 60-70% of the popular students, I am a hero in any conference. For the some 400 plus conference, I might have gone in these 25 years. One more bombarded question, sometime in 2014, it came from Geetham, BMS or BSM Engineering College, famous old college in Bangalore. When I was giving a lecture in IEEE Association, one student asked me two questions jovially. Sir, in that I was explaining the electron concept, proton concept, charge ideas. Because bipolar holes, electrons, carriers, bipolar. That fellow, sir, he picked up my slide after my lecture. Sir, in your slide, you have put atom, a schematic atom structure. The center nucleus is there. In nucleus, protons and neutrons are there. Protons are positive charged particles. Neutrons are chargeless particle. For atomic weight, we have to take the consideration of protons and neutrons. Atomic number of protons equal to number of electrons, then only atom is stable. I was telling in a colloquial way, first year students and some second year students. Sir, you told electrons are revolving around the nucleus, but not in single shell or part. Based on the energy consideration, some electrons will be in K shell, K, Kalpalata Reddy shell, K shell, L shell, Lavanya shell, Lalita shell, K, M shell, Mani shell. Sir, why K shell, L shell, M shell, N shell? Why not A shell, B shell, C shell, D shell? Odiyamma, even though Katarnak question like me sometime I used to talk to in the seminar hall, I'll ensure all the overage process like Kalpalata, Chandrasekhar to go out. Only some young faculty only I will allow. Because by seeing your faces, you may comment that he is really scientist or not different. And many friends I sent it out. So next question this fellow asked. Sir, the area of a circle formula is pi r square. Pi r square. But the area of a square is side into side a square. Why pi is not coming here, sir? I jovially told, this is, if you understand this concept by searching Google, I don't have time, then you will know what is the satellite launching concept, what is escape velocity, how we are placing maybe satellite in orbit, you understand. But then this also I told you find out. After some weeks, you send me the replies. But I don't want to tell those things here, you find out. Anyway, I'll skip this. See, this slide I made, there are 900 kilometers per hour super bullet trains in China, in Japan, and so other Western countries, even 1,600 also there. We can also have it provided we amalgamate our intelligent technology, merging hardware and software. Cost is the problem. Oh, once again, I want to tell to the young generation, first of all, engineering students should have calm, cool mind, not to be sentimental, not to be fanatic, not to be sensitive. Take it easy. But at the same time, those days have gone. I am an engineer, great feeling. He is just a social science fellow. He is a science fellow. Those days have gone. Simple example, most of our latest messages given by ISRO top people, first credit went to the success of Chandrayaan program, success of Mars program, first credit went to mathematics guys, computer guys, simulation modeling guys. Next came electronic group, because detectors, high speed, high mobility electron transistors, detectors, sensors. That means any modern electronic device, advanced application is based on sensing ability, resolving ability, sensing ability, detecting ability, high speed. So, my dear students, an advanced gadget used in advanced application, irrespective of defense or space, these characteristic features relies for its performance 3-4 concept: high level detection ability, high level resolving ability, high level sensing ability, movement of holes, electrons, mobility allows you speed, high speed computers, high speed. So simple example, basic sciences can be equated, correlated as a baby for baby. That baby, that subject grows, becomes a man or boy or girl. That can be equated, correlated with engineering. That boy or girl grows, becomes man or woman. That can be correlated, equated, or maybe equated for technology. That man or woman becomes wisdom-oriented persons, become gentleman or gentlewoman or lady. That is technology innovation. Don't underestimate basic sciences. Don't overestimate hardware sciences. Don't underestimate hardware. Don't overestimate software. Understand the real concept of emerging concept. All fields are merged, married together, become interdisciplinary, multidisciplinary. Even technology manager, project manager, from MBA, scheduling, time taskings, critical milestones, progress review, project evaluation review technique, PET, everybody is there. It's must nowadays. That evolved for the past 30 years. A simple example, the conventional concept of wire cutting machine in mechanical engineering, lathe machine in mechanical engineering, that can be labeled as simple machine earlier, 60s, 70s concept. Now software, hardware merged together, become instrument. Using your software, hardware concept, easiness, smart application, intelligent application, meeting your requirement, performance, okay. Smart system, intelligent system, instrument, that is the concept. The negative slides now. To enthuse in my boring subject lecture, in between, I put some maybe not negative, some thinking. Arts concept is that to become a very good engineer, to become a very good popular professor in the class, like Chandrasekhar, Kalpulata Reddy, good manager, principal, at least money. Arts concept is required. HOTS, higher order thinking skills, alternate thinking ability, good thinking ability. In that sense, youngsters can view these slides. Acrobatics means advanced sports, very advanced. There, student can negatively or positively get, since we have a lot of problems, population problem, still we don't have good maybe roads, health facilities, sanitation, because of health problem, maybe population problem. But youngsters can get like Bill Gates or any idea to produce a wonderful idea. Then you can make your country innovatively, you can earn royalties for the country. It's a common scene in most of the northern countries, Bihar. Oh, as I told, nano-electronics, cloud computing, big data analytics, nano-robotics, electronic waste recover and recycling. Then energy crises, your petroleum products will be over. But conventional photovoltaic technology using silicon panel are not giving more than consistent 6%. You have to invent new materials technology to convert sun energy into electricity. Apart from that, these are the emerging areas where any guys will take up future research or studies, M.Tech or whatnot in abroad. So these are the messages for opportunities in future for students. Pollution. I'll skip time factor. Why this is very important, yeah? Kalpalata madam, Malati madam, Lalita madam should not get fumed my slides. There is a joke, just message. Take it in a different and cool spirit. I told not to be sentimental, not to be sensitive, not to be fanatic. See, a very good scientist, very good professor, very good engineer, very good contributor to the society in the form of education, thinking and research. First of all, there should be an understanding between Mrs. Mani and Mr. Mani. Conducive environment, she has to create, I have to create. Understanding, lovely children should be there. There are only such hours coming, scientists will think differently, will have coolness, calmness, some conducive environment, that is must. It applies for both. If Dr. Mani is a sadist instead of scientist, then my wife will suffer. She may not contribute worthfully. I am not creating conducive environment. Similarly, Mrs. Mani is a Rajasi. Then my peace of mind, my conducive is gone. So, professor job, scientist job, most of the engineers job are noble jobs. See, being a scientist for the past maybe 30 years, see, passionately working, nowadays only passionately giving colorful lectures with colorful slides, different colors, one color for this seminar, another same message in different colors, but noble job. I enjoy. Being a scientist, I want to become a physics professor or basic electronics professor in future, or maybe director science and humanities, dean science and humanities. I would like to take one class every week, even daily also for physics, even to some extent ECE, typically because interdisciplinary. Or I may first come as director research after my retirement in 3 years. But I am not canvassing Kalpalata madam to get this post from your college. But then, this is very important. Now students look for this slide. The message I am going to talk only for students, you should love, like, enjoy living. So before, Mary, we know Superman, Spider-Man, these kind of cartoons sometime in 90s, 2000s. Once it's Spider-Man has unique capacity, solving any problem, helping others in distress. He will have the power, laying some cable wire, holding it, he will cross one building to another building, so on, he will solve the problem. Such a man got married to a madam, a lady. She is very Katarnak lady, Rakshasi. His real power is being utilized on force by her for drying clocks, that wire laying, cable laying. So see, after marriage. But same thing, if she is also contributing type, he should also cooperate. This message is very, very applicable. This is a psychology message, psychiatry message in this very stressed, strained. Many psychiatrists earn money. My son also doing MD, neurology and psychiatry. Even though he got highest rank, he would have opted for pediatrics. He would have opted for general medicine to get more dowry crores. But as a parent, I am a friend to my children. I said, it's which you like. So very important for engineers, doctors, scientists, professors, first requirement, first and foremost requirement, conducive environment in the family, frequency matching, understanding between Mr. and Mrs., even children. Such in that family, a person coming out, he can contribute little for education research. It's a must. So cool, calm, take it easy, no place for sensitiveness, no place for eccentric. So some may be cool, calm, that is different, timidity. Thumb rule for becoming a good engineer, contributing guy, good contributing doctor, contributing scientist, contributing professor, shaping the young minds, producing wonderful top class human resource. Today student, budding student, tomorrow budding engineer and contributing guy. See, one message I want to convey to the students. Students, attentively please listen. Lot of advantages contributed by internet technology, communication technology, information technology, because of this was possible. Good work contribution done by EC, typically electronic gadgets, so on. Wonderful societies enjoying. What not? Maybe mobile, TV, so many videos, Google Meet also. But equally, lot of dangers produced by these technologies. Youngsters get addicted, they misuse. One more thing, developing countries in general, India in particular, fanatic country, sentiment-full country, using obsolete, outdated communication devices among our young generation, they are spoiling, misusing. Very sad, very sad. Even I feel some of my second son using the, seeing that WhatsApp, I don't have WhatsApp. Anyway, Professor Chandrasekhar would have laughed. What this bloody fellow is a scientist. We don't have WhatsApp. He is asking me to send by email. But up to 1 o'clock. See, dangers also there. One more thing. Already, microelectronics technology, the silicon technology, which currently we are using on our gadget or gadgets based on that, matured enough, cost effective, we are producing. It took 50 years. But now, there are plans to merge existing silicon technology, mature technology, existing microelectronic technology with emerging nanotechnology to bring down the south. Size. Mainly nano means superior properties, material properties. Naturally, nano electronic based components will perform very, very better. Cost reduction, size reduction, everything. But then, dangers. Developed countries, Western countries, already strong in microelectronics technology. They immediately develop nanotechnology, nanorobotics, but they will control economically, militarily, the underworld country, third world countries, develop dangers also there. Emerging technologies, more dangers for other other aspects. Anyway, this slide I don't want to discuss, but this for some gap, maybe joke gap for students. Read and you decide. As I told, engineering students are very weak in English in general, communication skills, criticality thinking, flexibility, managing, situational aspect, very important. You want to be a smart student. Earlier, clever student concept is different. Clever means cunning plus knowledge. Smart students, knowledge like that. Clever students, smart students. These are typical. If you open up your computer, laptop, if you see packaging concept, how intelligently in a small available space, variety of components ranging from transistor, diode, etc. packed. When you on this device, continuously operate for 5 hours, electronic noise concept, mainly eating concept, then you have to work for ideas, address the challenges of heat dissipation, cooling devices, electronic packaging, definitely. Because you are going to use narrow gadgets to deal with 110 crores of Aadhaar data, big data analytics, cloud computing, naturally. Repeatedly I told, so packaging is a wonderful emerging electronics field area for future research, future studies also. Earlier conventional radar communication, conventional VLSI, that too most lower facilities to do hardware project. But now this is the trend. Apart from nano-electronics, nano-robotics, interlinked. Think of any young guys. To give the flavor to the young students, especially ECE, typically CSE students, earlier technology is called macro technology or microelectronics technology, silicon technology, bulk technology, colloquially. But now emerging technology is nano technology. Nano means 10 power minus 9 centimeter. Micro means 10 power minus 6. Picoelectronics, pico means 10 power minus 12. But these kind of vacuum electronics, centimeters, decimeters. Then microelectronics came millimeter to microns. That is the thumb rule of microelectronics technology, which we are using. The students will appreciate to know the concept which I am going to explain in a colloquial way. Producing 10 power minus 9 type of very small size components using bigger size, very bigger size preparation producing equipment. But in that equipment, attached tools, sophisticated thickness control, very accurate composition control. Suppose if you are preparing gallium arsenide, a binary direct band gap semiconductor, which is having 5 times faster mobility than silicon. That's why gallium arsenide, gallium phosphide, indium phosphide, gallium nitride components used to develop superfast computers. That computer cost will be 10 lakhs. But your laptop, your system will be 80,000 because those systems are used, your silicon-based components. Using bigger size machine with sophisticated purity control. If you have vacuum level of 10 power minus 12 torque, high purity concept. To have clean environment, no contamination, high purity environment, use high level vacuum in the lower order. A confused statement. 10 power minus 12 torque pressure bar. That is a low level vacuum value. But high level vacuum gives purity. You can diagnose like ultrasound after pregnancy, finally 9th month or 8th month, ultrasound to find out whether dowry coming by fetus or dowry giving female fetus, diagnostic tools. Such machines produces 10 power minus K minus 9 small size component nanoscale technology. That is the emerging technology. Big machines making small size products in the range of 10 power minus 9, which are having better thermal conductivity, better density, better electrical properties, optical properties. My dear ECE student, EEE students, any electronic component, gadget, system, relies, works on 2 or 3 critical characteristics of a material, semiconductor material, which you are going to use to make chip and your ultimate component. Electrical properties, electrical conductivity for metals, but by bipolar semiconductors, hole mobility, HOLE, hole, is positive. P-type semiconductor. Electrons majority carriers N-type. By doing pure silicon, by phosphorus doping pentavalent, no, N-type example. P-type, by example, zinc. I may not be knowing exactly the elemental. That is the way you make it in a way. That can be done using this machine diagnostically. But earlier concept, molecular manufacturing, microelectronics, macro technology, bulk technologies using smaller machines producing bigger size. But then, so I was shocked when I went to so-called Geetham University for a PhD viva in triple department, and they asked me to give 2-part lecture, like I am sharing with you now, on the day, 1 hour in the morning, 1 hour in the evening. But many, even middle-level faculty members, they think that electronics industry, semiconductor industry, most of the ECE, triple fellows knows, the major main semiconductors are silicon, or germanium, or in 70s emerging binary gallium arsenide, silicon carbide, zinc oxide, gallium nitride, cadmium telluride, their ternaries, mixtures, composition deferred, all these things. But it is not the case when you talk about aerospace electronics, aero defense electronics, high purity silver, high purity gold, high purity platinum, for all, for you people, ornament gold daily increasing, no? 10 grams on Mala, maybe 55,000 next week. But these are electronic material in IPT form, which are very much used in space electronics to connect one component to another component by having a high purity, 99.98 purity with the doping of that purity to make wire. 24 carat gold, you cannot make wire. You cannot make sheets. 22 carat only can be bended, and that's why all ornaments. But using, when I mean 99.99, use zinc or copper of that purity, that gold is used. I asked one student, one girl student, 1 kilo aluminium. If you go to vessel shop to buy maybe vessels like Anda Gunda, 200 to 400 rupees, 1 kilo aluminium. But if you go to gold shop, now peak gold rates, platinum rates, 1 kilo is maybe, I think maybe 45, maybe some 55 lakhs, 60 lakhs. Platinum even 70, 80 lakhs. Why gold is costly? Precious metals, noble metals, compared to other metals. She told abundance, processing cost. Many young students, they know electrical materials like copper, aluminium, electrical materials. But mercury is a wonderful electronic material to have amalgamations in space electronics application. I asked one student, aluminium is a metal. It is in solid form. Iron is a metal. It is in solid form. Gold is a metal in solid form. But mercury is in liquid form. Which property, material property, decides a material to be in liquid state, solid state, to find out? See, chemistry point of view, if you dissolve sodium chloride salt, it readily dissolves in water. Same sodium chloride salt is not dissolved in kerosene density. Why it is not dissolved? It's an electronic, binary, world is binary. On, off, one, zero, good, bad, low, high, rich, poor. Electronics, wonderful field. Find out mercury and that other kind of things. See, coming to 1930s, 40s, 50s, one mercury radio on packaging, it will be 5 feet by 5 feet. This tube does the job of size, you 3 centimeters. Does the now, thanks to planar electronics, thanks to development of microelectronics, now we are aiming for non-electronics, variety of new materials, their preparation, their doping, their fabrication using CAD or simulation, whatever tools. Then now, this is being done by, after packaging nowadays, 5 by 2, 5.75 centimeter transistor and diode. The miniaturization, size is ready, performance is improving. You can just a colloquial view slide. As I already explained, the dangers of technology, especially information. But remember, alternative thinking, logical thinking, rational thinking, different thinking, alternative thinking, logical thinking, rational thinking, different thinking is the hallmarks of scientist, professor, or engineer, doctor. See, people are nowadays thinking about mixtures, alloys form, compound forms of different electronic materials. Then for different band gap applications, laser applications, LED application, kind of different crystals in thin films, different forms, alternative thinking. Anyway, this is self-respect, self-esteem, self-confidence, self-control, facing the failures, being calm, cool guy should be there. So most of the gentlewomen are good doing science, cooperation is there in research field. But some people like, I don't know what to name, ladies, difficult. This slide, my dear young students, especially young faculty, put attention. See left-hand side, right-hand side. Left-hand side, size is shrinking from centimeter to millimeter to micron. Micron level, our standard microelectronics technology, whatever we are enjoying, silicon technology. But complexity is increasing. Now, we are thinking about nanoelectronics nanometer range. 1 × 10⁻¹ meter is nanometer. But another forecast for another 25 years, 2050 is picoelectronics, 10⁻¹² meters. But come to the right side, cost is coming down, failure rate is coming down. EC engineer, triple engineer, semiconductor scientists like me should rewind in their brains in these 50 years to know the defects in your silicon crystal, which you are going to use to make a chip. Any point defects, atoms are arranged in a proper manner, in an absolute perfect manner, ideal manner. We have X-ray probing technology, X-ray refraction, X-ray matter technology. Then to know any after, once you cut the wafer, cutting, polishing, butcher, with this tamanna actress, isolated cheek, very polished wafer is required. On which only you are going to use your VLSI, IC fabrication technology to realize your component, polished. So, for that polishing systems, scanning electron microscopy, atomic force microscopy, sophisticated failure test kits, procedures, materials preparation techniques, crystal growth techniques, packaging techniques in clean room to avoid atmospheric contamination. How many new materials? Apart from silicon germanium, new material is gallium arsenide, indium phosphide, zinc oxide, gallium indium phosphide, gallium indium arsenide by ternaries, quaternaries. Wonderful achievements made by the materials engineers to variety of new CAD tools, design tools, simulation, modeling, gate length, source, everything changing. Wonderful electronic problems in right side. See the vacuum tubes years 1930s, then invention of silicon germanium semiconductor properties, preparing them in high purity form, making them as a thin film deposit. That is the revolution took place 1960s, 50s, planar transistors, vacuum tubes replacement, then integrated circuits, low scale integration, large scale integration, very large scale integration, ultra large scale integration, now MEMS for mixing VLSI with MEM concept for nanoelectronics, variety of developments. Earlier, with Philips Hollander, when Color TVs first came, not LEDs, Flatron, 1 lakh pieces produced by Philips factory in Holland. If it comes to the market, out of 1 lakh, at least 2,000 pieces will come for repair, immediately selling in 1 or 2 months. Now, the failure rate has been reduced, probing technology, failure testing, material high quality, not in 1 lakh pieces, 1 or 2 pieces. That is a real achievement in all aspects. Good material, pure material, high quality, everything. In 2035, nanoelectronics, existing size of your computer, your mobile phone, your laptop will become 1/4 size. As material consumption will be less. Nano transistor means superior property. 5 atoms, maybe few nanometer. Now existing transistor in your laptop, after packaging, maybe few centimeters, few tensimeter will become few microns after nano transistor packaging. But ruggedness, stability, maybe lifetime, withstanding, humidity, high temperature, low temperature, challenges being addressed, research work going on. If the challenges are overcome in another 10 years, nano size laptop by 1/4, like that will be available, pen drive size. See, it was very difficult to produce white light, but by having many students, may not be knowing, from 2 years back, a young friend of mine, whom I chaired his session sometime in 90s, 2000s, got Nobel Prize. A team member, 43 years old guy, Japanese guy, for inventing gallium nitride, which can produce white light by some technology, solid state lighting. Now, candescent bulbs, fluorescent bulbs, almost 30% removed by emerging light emitting diodes. Semiconductors can make light. Real achievement, Nobel Prize for anybody, LED, Japanese group, gallium nitride, producing white light was difficult. Look, but this is also a wonderful area. But to me, we'll make avakai, urugai, idli podi technologies. How many students, they really understood when they want to know, curious about nano-electronics, in what way it is different from present-day micro-electronics, present-day silicon electronics, what beneficial features it will offer. But first of all, nano concept has to be understood in a different sense. Many people, crazy Indians, like many scientists, many pervasive kind of fellow, role of nanotechnology in mechanical engineering. One fellow writes a paper. Role of mechanical engineering in nanotechnology. Role of medicine in nanotechnology, role of nanotechnology in medicine. Role of nanotechnology in agriculture, role of agriculture in nanotechnology. Role of biotechnology in nanotechnology, but nanotechnology in biotechnology. But nanotechnology in others is the current trend. But I am 100% convinced for the past 11 years during my talks as an educative, I want to get educated. I am closely observing role of new sophisticated electronic materials like gallium arsenide, silicon carbide, gallium nitride, even cadmium telluride, so on their binaries, their mixtures. Definitely role of nanotechnology is making very good impact on electronics. Nanoelectronics has wonderful impact feature, yes. But how many students do you know? I think peacock, when conducive rainbow, some after stopping rain, some sun rays, rainbow forms in certain direction, fulfilling reflections, light scan, when the peacock dances, the variety of, it was good look, which feather gives different colors, reflections. But real truth is that God provided, created a powder, pons powder, talcum powder in feather cap, in the peacock feathers. When light falls on the feather, different talcum powder is already there. Different sizes, maybe 62 nanometer, 32 nanometer in one place, 80 nanometer, 79. When light falls on the different size nanoparticles, then reflection process, light scan, then the color is due to, because of nano sized some powder form particles are there in the peacock feather. That is the nano concept. Colloquial. I told no time because of time. Science concept, engineering concept, technology concept, technology innovation concept, my dear young students, irrespective of EC, EEE, all students should know. Similarly, basic research, applied research, research and development, then prototype working model development, then mass production, manufacturing should be thorough. It is must know, whether EC student, EEE student, when they want to understand the manufacturing environment. Underestimate manufacturing in general. Don't underestimate the contribution of hardware. So hardware, simply we don't put efforts. You don't have system, you can't test your software. See, the material efforts to devices, efforts to gadget. So don't underestimate. You should go for intelligent technology, merging software and hardware. There is confusion. Among the young middle-level faculty, even M.Tech students, B.Tech students, already silicon material is there for the past 50 years. Germanium semiconductor material, electronic material is there. Silicon technology, which now we are using, microelectronology is there. Developed, matured, cost-effective technology, which took 30 years. That doesn't mean that newly coming material, gallium nitride, gallium arsenide, silicon carbide, indium phosphide, any variety of material cannot in a single day, cannot replace existing technologies or existing silicon, germanium semiconductors. It can complement in certain areas, we require very small size laptop gadgets. But in certain areas, space, large size thrust motor, rocket motor, large size solar panels. So there will be a role for macro bulk. There is a role for emerging nano size. It cannot be replaced in a simply like that. It can supplement, complement. It will evolve after some time, after some decades, new things emerge. Students should understand. Another concept I want to enthuse the students of ECE people. As we know, not only silicon, germanium, other semiconductors have entered the gold, mercury, silver, platinum, diamond also in that sense. Diamond is a hard material, different form of carbon. Pencil is a graphite, but that structure decides which structure wonderful. But basically, diamond is a carbon material. Its structure decides it's a hard material. So diamond is a wonderful electronic material as far as space electronics, defense electronics applications are concerned. Even suppose Mani's son's, my grandson Mary's Aishwarya daughter, my grandson cannot be as white as Aishwarya Rai or her daughter. He may not be as dark as Ravana color like Mani. In between color will come. Similarly, efforts are underway to mix both material. Earlier, we know silicon is a wonderful electronic material, germanium is a wonderful optical material, emerging gallium arsenide are wonderful, high frequency, high bandwidth material, more application, high temperature tolerance, high radiation tolerance, high frequency, high power application. But then, mixing germanium and silicon, is it possible to have such a possible combination to synthesis, follow chemistry rules, physics rules, materials, physics and material chemistry rules, we used to call Rigaud's law, then other zinc oxide research is going on. So, this slide I would suggest, especially youngsters, I was somewhere hinting nano-electronics. I was hinting packaging is very important as far as electronics development is concerned. Nanorobotics is important. Cloud computing is important. Data analytics is important. But then, all these things will be revolutionized in another 10 years based on the technology forecast in the field of advanced electronics materials and devices development for this thing. But nano-electronics, why it is standing as a special compared to existing technology? Nano-sized material we are going to use. What is the difference? Suppose if you have 1 cm by 1 cm bulk silicon sample. If it is possible, you develop a nano-silicon material having 5 silicon atoms, 10⁻⁹ meter scale. That is nano-silicon. This is bulk silicon. You measure the properties, thermal conductivity, thermal expansion, density, melting point, especially electrical properties, optical properties, mechanical properties for bulk. You tabulate it. You measure the duly synthesized only 10⁻⁹ nano scale silicon having 5 atoms, or nano dimension silicon. You measure same these properties. You compare it. Nanoscale, 5 atom contained nano-silicon system will have superior properties. That ultimately, when you use that nano-silicon based entity for making components, its performance will be 5 times, 10 times superior in all aspects. And mainly, the consumption of silicon weight material will be less. Naturally, cost will come down. We are using the existing microelectronic transistor, which we are using in my tab now, I am using for MIT. After packaging, assume 0.5 centimeter approximation. But after developing your nanoscale 5-atom silicon material, you decide nano transistor of silicon. Silicon-based nano-size transistor. After packaging, its size will be 0.5 micron roughly. See the size reduction. Packaging, its size reflects the ultimate product. Packing density, I labeled energy efficient, everything. But challenge is, the tab which I am using, where the Lalita madam, Madhavi Lata madam using the tab, is a proof. Tab is based on, laptop is based on existing silicon technology, microelectronic technology of our present age. Proved one, rugged one. It can handle the maybe the harsh conditions like humidity, temperature, radiation, rugged one. It can average maybe 3 to 4, 5 years. But the new gadget which we are going to develop based on emerging nano-sized diodes, nano-sized transistors, nano-sized capacitors, nano-sized resistors, it will be small mobiles, phone, present mobile phone size, the laptop. But how it will handle these kind of harsh conditions is the very challenges. Now work is going on. The outcome will come maybe 5-10 years. But anyway, in that way, definitely nano electronics will take a lead. One more, some viewpoint I am throwing. I am not expert. I am not going to detail, my dear young faculty members. Still, confusion or debates are going on, two or three concepts. Now, IC fabrication is nothing but of microelectronics technology, is nothing but of silicon technology, nothing but of ontological technology. Existing VLSE will be automatically directly used for producing nano-electronic components. Answer, I don't know. Whether that the MEMS concept for sensor and all these things, no? That can be some concept of MEMS will be merged with VLSI. Then a procedure of developing technology, fabrication technology concept, thumb rolls, CAD tools, whatever, will be like that. I don't know the answer, but these are these debates. Some actions, some works are going on, but not published. Critical. Students, curiosity can check. Anyway, no time. This slide particularly, I want to project for young students. Yes, there are a lot of job opportunities to solve the industrial problem, to solve the man-made problem. As it says, one report says in another 30 years, existing oil resource, coal resources will be outdated, because we have overused petroleum resources, coal resources. Naturally, we have to look for another energy source that is converting sunlight into electricity. But for the past 50 years, we are doing, mankind is exploring silicon material technology, developing silicon photovoltaic cell to convert sun energy into electricity by having large panels present. But running the plants, maintenance plant, the plants, resistance losses, ohmic losses, mainly silicon technology is capital intensive. Silicon melting point is 1424 degree. Energy intensive, capital intensive. But silicon is a direct band gap material. You cannot go more than practically 8%. Theoretical people, laboratory people will tell that we can achieve conversion light energy to electricity conversion 20%. Number. The solar panel selling pillow putting on the roof, you will tell. But afterwards, you will realize dust and ohmic losses, different. 9 o'clock sun in this direction, 12 o'clock in the straight direction, 4 o'clock energy conversion, everything. But new technology is coming up. Silicon is a single element. The band gap is fixed at 1.4 or something. I don't know the Buddha old man, but somewhere. But you can, in white light, sunlight, there are 7 colors. 7 colors have different wavelengths. But your silicon material band gap will absorb only particular lights, wavelengths, particular component, red with gear and all these things. Now people are using, instead of single silicon, amorphous silicon, polycrystalline silicon panel, why don't you use like burger, bun, spinach, onion, some meat, whatever, that is a spinach, multi-junction layers, different material, first silicon layer, thin film form, then germanium, then gallium arsenide, all make a triple junction cell. So yellow wavelength will be absorbed by silicon, red wavelength will be germanium. Ultimately, using light concentration, collimation, condensation in a single place. If you put convex or concave, I don't remember, you put paper or some cotton, after some time it burnt. Concentration, light concentration, by concentrating, creating heat, reduce the size of the silicon panel because costly. Using nano size cells, using concentrating optics, condensing optics, collimating optics, create 2000 degree centigrade. Then 100 degree you make channels, boil water, convert heat energy into mechanical energy, turbine running. Then you make heat energy production by concentrated nano solar voltaic technology. 90% heat energy, electrical energy, 10% use so real photovoltaic effect. So one student asked me, what is the difference between solar cell and photovoltaic cell? I told the difference between house and home. Hey, electrical engineer, water, volt, ampere, that's all. I told different space agencies are trying. Oh, solar panel, why producing one unit electricity by idle power 5 rupees, produce 5 to 6 rupees. Statistical report says price reports, but producing one unit electricity by burning coal or petroleum methane gas, 12 rupees producing one unit electricity cost. But producing one unit electricity by having large size silicon photovoltaic panel, whatever the people argue, it comes into 16 rupees. Why cost after doing so much research for the past 30 years, producing electrical energy using silicon solar panel, even though going, it's not advocated nowadays. It has cost factor. It is not cost effective. Because silicon technology itself is costly. Simple solar cell. Cell is different concept. Arranging cells, module, arranging arrays. Then the quality of the finish, ohmic losses, contacts, then dust problem. The student should understand whatever cells will produce direct current. But to grid, you have to convert that direct current into alternate current and feed into where involves money, technology. That's why silicon solar based production is not enthusiastic, but still there. See, in English language, you arrange alphabets, you get words, you arrange words, you get sentence, you arrange sentences, you get paragraph, you arrange paragraph, you get right text. But if you arrange the text, you get an essay, you get your philosophy. But telling is easy, like money, like philosopher. But that is the reason. This also very good area. Like packaging, nanoelectronics, I strongly advocate for future generation of the students, lot of scope for core subjects, energy. Now copper indium diselenide, different cells, this multi-junction, gallium arsenide, variety of things. My dear students, the real achievement, knowing the semiconductor properties of germanium silicon, one revolution, part of one revolution, producing high purity silicon germanium, removing unnecessary impurities, making device quality silicon germanium material by purification refining. Then converting amorphous electronic material silicon germanium gallium arsenide into crystalline. Crystalline materials are properly the periodicity material. Crystalline material properties are superior than amorphous. Amorphous is a commercial application, low value, high value addition. But then these 50 years of research led. Light subject was separate, electric light separate, electric was separate. They two got married, new baby came, micro-optoelectronics has come, micro-electronics has come, micro-optoelectronics has come, now nano-electronics. Real achievement in this 20th century. Because of these new materials, tested, prepared, their preparation system, their property studying characterization system, their electrical and everything, then their conference making. Wonderful achievement. These materials, it is not that all triple EEC people should go for modeling simulation software job. They are like me, a medium guy, who is 75% in BSc MSc, not a low average girl student, not type like guy. I took it to MSc Physics-Electronics 4 years course. MSc, my qualification, MSc Physics-Electronics. This also one can do well. Always its value is, was there, is there, will be there. Lot of opportunities, any research, higher studies. Future, transparency, see-through, new materials, new design technologies will rule the world. As I told for youngsters, for subject fellows, basic sciences fellows, need not worry too much. Only software can do well. No. These are the man-made problems where solutions should come from teaching, developing manpower, industrial solutions, this electronic waste, energy problem, water. See, how many, I was really felt pity, many M.Tech students, the third year, fourth year student doesn't know the at least fundas of they are studying electronics engineering. The same one student I asked, why nowadays digital multimeters are prepared to test an electric component, nowadays analog multimeters? One parent told, this is easy to understand. Accuracy, you can, because small currents, small signals, small energies measure in the small components. Digital multimeter, 0.1, 0.0 in accuracy, nobody is telling. How many students they know about transistor? Many students don't know how to define active components, how to define passive components. What are electrical components? What are measuring kits? Also, many students know. Funny thing is that my suggestion to youngsters students, when you are talking about electronics field, electronics communication field. Electronic comes basis is in itself is the silicon, no? Bulk single crystals. This is the foundation for your any gadget. They should know their properties, as I told, all these things. At least like multiplication table, when myself, Professor Chandrasekhar Reddy, Kalpalatha Reddy, doing those things, by they should memorize 20th table, multiplication table. Like that, they should have fundamental idea about germanium, about the silicon, and the people who want to know nano-electronics, these kind of things, nano-robotics, they should know silicon carbide, different material emerging, already emerging, gallium arsenide like this. See, this bulk crystal, using mechanical engineering concept, chemical engineering concept, this is the substrate, wafer we used to call it. You are going to use your IC fabrication technology, ultra large scale integration technology to create your active regions like source drain and all lithography, implantation, probing, masking, etching, so on, so on, so on. This is the basis. It comes from single crystal. So students should at least, maybe this is a very sophisticated crystal growth technology. Because you have to use 1440 degree centigrade, you have to convert into liquid by heating. Then slowly you have to put a seed, control the thermal balance, mass, temperature gradient, then you pull the crystal. But while so much sophisticated technology, pulling crystals should be crystalline. All silicon atoms are properly arranged. There should not be any defects, any vacancies. So then only we used to come. Device grade. Then butcher or butcher, this is the wafer. This is the foundation. Right? Like you are building brick, this is the one. See, on which only you will use. This is the base material for deposition of thin films, for producing any components. See, anyway, this is anyway. When my title says, special electronic materials and their components, devices, gadgets means in general electrical conductivity, electrical mobility, holes concentration, maybe electrons concentration, those decides functioning of the functioning of the electronic component. But then you want to use electronic component into device and gadget, ultimately final device, what characteristics, beneficial, performance oriented feature you are looking for, as I told, high mobility for high speed applications. For that, no inclusions, no defects will be there in your chip that originates from substrate, your crystal. High speed, resolving ability, detecting ability, sensing ability. God give an example of when kingfisher bird catches its prey, compensating with such sensing ability, such fastness, such all levels. That is the characteristic features that are being developed for space application sector, NASA, our European Space Agency, Japanese Space Agency, our space agency, to develop special detectors, special transistors, ballistic transistors, high mobility electron transistor, build up a transistor are completely different. Using 99.9 purity, structurally superior, electrically superior, optically superior, thermally superior, mechanically superior, material based, finally component device. So for realizing high-end applications, special applications. See, different material. This is a ternary, three elemental. You can use more combustion gap. You can use it for different applications. Band gap. Packaging is very vital. I explain. See, there is no place for sensitivity, sentimentality, fanatics. As a jovially, if I ask a girl, first of all, an engineering girl, engineer, scientist, doctor, professor, should not give importance to sentiments, not to be sensitive. If I ask a girl, M.Tech girl, what is your mother tongue, Tirupati College girl, she will tell Telugu. As a sarcastic Brahmanandam style comedy man to irritating others, sadist fellow, irritating others, enjoying himself like money. What is your father tongue, your auntie tongue, your mummy tongue? She will understand, label me as a mad fellow. But then even to embrace her, what is your boyfriend tongue? But an English professor with neutral mind, research for 5 years. I took it from a research topic. He replaced the colloquial word of mother tongue, housewife words, by putting homemaker, home language or native language. If you apply scrutiny, that is essence of scientist, engineer, these two words withstand. There is no confusion. People like me, mother tongue, father tongue, auntie tongue, boyfriend tongue, girlfriend tongue, lover tongue. That is the beauty of research. Analyzing with neutral mind. Housewife has been replaced with homemaker, home engineer. That is the contribution of the researcher thinking differently, alternatively, logically. Because I asked some girl, she should not feel like cinematic. Most of the South Indians, cinematic, sentimental pulls. No. But engineer, doctor, professor, scientist, not too much inclined to that. How many young faculty people explain the concept of prototype, test chip? They should correlate, interrelate concepts of research, basic research, applied research, converting research ideas into application oriented, then working model. They should try. So students will get enthused during their dissertation work projects.
Good afternoon, sir.
From sir.
No, sir, sir. We need to wind up, sir, because 12 o'clock we have given slots for them because of that.
I'm not listening your voice clearly because I have taken too much time, huh?
Yes, sir. So, because we have given time to 12 o'clock, sir, we need to wind up this system because we go fast. Hello?
Okay. So, Professor Kalpalata and HODs of ECEEE, if any students wants this, they can circulate. There are applications on real steps. I highlighted some important steps. These are VLSI steps or procedures of fabrication of integrated circuits, monolithic integrated circuits, but these are important. If a starting is very good electrically, structurally, optically, then there are various steps. I named a few, but there are oscillation, variety of things. Even enlarged, I made it some 15, but 45 steps. But these are now challenging the quality. Where failure rate, if you thought and testing is very, very vital. Okay. And I'll skip some of these slides. How many students they know the concept of device gadget system? They should maybe jovially they can church, enjoy themselves. So many special properties. That's why these materials are technologically important for high-end aerospace and defense applications. Special materials. Apart from silicon means high purity, not consumer grade. Packaging, contamination control. We use special to package injections, tablets, and capsules. They use 1000 class. But for high-end electronics application, contamination-free packaging very important. We use class clean rooms 1000-1000s. As I told, special components and devices, in special aero defense, aerospace, and space electronics defense application for missiles and all these things. Anyway, I told about electronic waste dumping. That is also wonderful area. Yeah? In future, in another 10 years, nano-electronics. This is one of the emerging high frequency, high temperature, high band gap value also. Strength is the wonderful material. Coming, I'll wind up in 2 minutes. As I told, we are taking low-grade gallium and low-grade silicon, low-grade germanium 99%. We use electrochemical, metallurgical, cleaning, rinsing, filtration, distillation, all kind of refining, purification principles to reduce the impurities that are present in your material, which impurities alter your conductivity and refractive index. That is the reason why we want to develop high purity individual elements, individual compounds. That is, we give it to our users, space and defense. They use our high purity material. They prepare components and devices. In cement hydrobite, our role is to provide device quality starting material for substrate. Then variety of, as I told, disciplines, various disciplines, quality control plays a dominant role. Physics, chemistry, material science, your ECEEE chemical mechanical. Gallium is a liquid metal. Its melting point is 30 degrees centigrade. You have to use special metallurgical crystal growth approaches to purify from 99 grade to 99 grade, removing or controlling impurities. Then no equipment, no material high purity will separate to India. Not published data. You have to use as an interdisciplinary team, physics fellow, chemistry fellow, material science fellow, instrument development fellow, even ECE fellow to give feedback. We develop indigenous systems, develop lot of labs, basic type systems, do lot of studies, basic studies, then enhance the scale of preparation. These are the parameters, material science parameters, temperature parameters, we control. Ultimately, we prepare. But challenge is that our input material 1 kilo gallium, 3N pure. We are supposed to make 5N pure or 7N pure. Yield is very, very low. Only 30-40% yield is very low. Challenge. Then we use special acids, high purity acid, special clean rooms to avoid the contamination from the environment. That is clean room. There is a definition students can take. Then special packaging. Then various testing, electrical, optical, structural, chemical properties. We test the material. We send the material for third party testing also. Since we ourselves test and certify, no. This is a space grade procedure. Then use our material, prepare some the component compounds in collaboration with Calcutta University, IIS, Bangalore. Some products using our own input material, we did it for research purpose. Then we doping, preparing thin films also important. Most of the electronic devices, 99% are thin film, junction transistor, everything thin film based. We did, gallium nitride is emerging material. We did some major project. I think enough. Electronic waste, you can recover certain silver, gold, all these things. Don't throw recycling. Thank you very much. Sorry, I have taken much of your time for lunch problem.
No, no problem. No problem, sir. Thank you, sir. They have some other remedial classes. So that is the reason, sir. No problem, sir.
I'll be happy to tell, but lunchtime, if you have any questions, welcome. Once again, I thank the dynamic military officer, principal. God bless her. The nice opportunity, all HODs, those who coordinate, all women, faculty, and youngsters, my students. Yes, madam told, I will be comfortable. My lecture will be very good. Many people told, when I am in the hall, I won't stand in front of, I will be wandering. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for this. Madam,
Sir, to accept our invitation is permitted, sir. Your session is very inspiring and inspiring, sir. You have enriched all the students in the role of nanomaterials in the field of space and defense applications. Just I personally thank you, sir, for sharing moral values to all of us. So many tell all the information regarding the technology, but have shared knowledge in, with respect to the models you have shared, that you had respect people from different fields and technologies, and you might be patient and cool mind even something goes wrong. Thank you for sharing such knowledge, sir. And I feel express our profound gratitude.
Madam, your voice is not clear, madam.
Hello.
You people voice.
Now, sir.
My voice was audible, madam.
Hello.
Your voice is very good, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. Now it's okay, madam.
Yeah. Sir, okay. Is it okay, sir?
Any questions, comments?
Okay, sir. So actually, I want to thank my principal ma'am also, sir, organizing this webinar, and thank my HOD, sir, for his moral support and guidance. So I would like to thank you very much, sir, for organizing such an informative session. What sir and Matt has told, so we will organize another session.
Yes, madam, I am following.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, sir. Mani, sir.
Thanks, Professor. Chandra?
Yes, sir.
What about
thank you.
Professor is also there?
Sir? Hello, sir?
Triple E, Professor?
No, sir. He left, actually. He was in some other meeting. He was just left.
Professor Chandra.